At this time, we ask you, please take a moment, silence your phones. At the Green Room 42, the use of photography and recording is strictly encouraged. And please tag us in your pictures and your videos at the Green Room 42. If you need to use the restroom, please exit through the doors you came in through, and they're located down the hall on the other side of the elevators. And if you'd like to order something during the performance, our servers will be available throughout the duration of the show, where you can use the table number on your lamp to order online. With those few necessities out of the way, I want you to please put your hands together for the reason you're all here. Five questions with James and Jane.
Hello!
Hi!
How is everybody doing? Sheridan, my wonderful glory, can you hit our track?
No glasses.
We're the two youngest people that you ever did see. Younger than springtime or a newborn baby. And our show is gonna surely make you shout.
Yes, ma'am.
Talk about five questions with James and Jam.
Welcome. Welcome. To the second show in our residency here.
Number two.
Fabulous Green Room 42.
Yes.
We're happy to be here.
We have five questions. It's all numbers. I like that.
Yes. On the keys is the wonderful Drew Watke. Yes.
Hey, everybody.
We have the marvelous Miss Farah Alvin, who's going to come up in a minute.
Yes.
And the person who's making us look beautiful and sound great. The fantastic, the scintillating, the wonderful Sheridan.
Sheridan. We love you, Sheridan.
Yes, yes. Well, my name is John Andrew Morrison, known as Jam, and this magnificent, wonderful, delicious human is...
Donna Murphy.
Yes.
James Jackson Jr.
James Jackson Jr.
Yes.
And here's how tonight's gonna work.
Yes.
We have some songs. Mm-hmm. We have some entertainments.
We have some shimmery outfits. I love the back of this.
Shimmery outfits.
Yeah.
S. Joy, schmaploofery, and foolishness.
I love it.
So the first thing that we do is a medley. Mm-hmm. And we've been enjoying doing these mashups of foolishness and schmaploofery. And tonight,
you're going to have to spell schmaploofery.
Schmaploofery is spelled S-C-H-M-P-O-O-L-F-R-E-Y.
Oh. Wow. Wow.
Wow.
Wow. Okay.
Hashtag schmaploofery. tonight's medley.
What's it about?
Well, tonight's medley is called...
Do you want to dedicate it to anyone?
I want to dedicate it to some people who done me wrong.
Ooh. Oh. You don't ever want to see JM mad.
You'd never want to see me mad. It happens rarely.
I've seen it both of the times it's happened. I was nearby.
You were. Mm-hmm. Luckily, it wasn't directed at you yet.
Couldn't be.
Yet. But this medley tonight is called... I wish... A motherfucker would. Nigga, this is the 15th motherfucking time that I called and left your ass messages.
I done text your bitch ass, and you ain't responded to nothing. Who the fuck is you out there with?
Who the fuck is you out there with? You think I'm stupid?
My girls already done put me up on your ass tonight.
Uh-huh. When you get home, I got some news for your bitch ass. Why you coming home 5 a.m? Something's going on, can I smell your dick?
Oh, ladies. Okay, I get it, I love the song, Smell Your Dick, it's a classic, right? But maybe there are some other ways to say that it is the opening of
we
the show.
We just start, Smell Your Dick is a classic.
It is.
Okay.
It's part of the American songbook.
It is.
People don't know.
Okay, great, yes.
People should study it.
Great
it's
American
brilliant.
Song.
Like
I
the
have
song
the Ella Fitzgerald version on my
Ella
phone.
The Ella Fitzgerald version
Listen,
is wonderful.
I love it as much as the next girl, but can...
Well, then what do you want, Drew?
Okay, I bet if I play the start of something else that I mentioned earlier, you'll be able to figure that out.
Well,
you ready?
We'll see.
All right.
Oh, this is a good one. The motherfucker wishes he would.
Right
Now he's probably slow dancing with a bleach blonde tramp, and she's probably getting frisky. Right now he's probably buying her some fruity little drink, 'cause she can't shoot whiskey. Right now he's probably up behind her with a pool geek, showing her how to shoot a combo. And he don't know. Popped his lip shit and made it go,
You were smelling his lip shits down on Cicero.
You were squishing his lip shits doing number 17, the spread eagle.
I gotta pee.
What doesn't kill you makes you stronger.
Stand a little taller.
Doesn't mean I'm lonely when I'm alone.
What doesn't kill you makes a fighter.
But stuff's even lighter.
Doesn't mean I'm over, 'cause you're gone.
Because I'm stronger than yesterday. Now it's nothing but my way. My loneliness ain't killing me no more. I'm stronger. To the left, to the left. Everything you own in a box, to the left. To the left, to the left.
I guess I just lost my husband. I don't know where he went.
I'm gonna drink my money. I'm not gonna pay his rent.
I got a brand new attitude, and I'm gonna wear it tonight.
I wanna start a fight. I wanna start a fight.
Na 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 na. I wanna start a fight.
So what? I'm still a rock star. I got my rock moves. And I don't need you, and guess what? I'm having more fun, and now that we're done, I'm gonna show you tonight. I'm alright, I'm just fine, and you're a tool, so what? I'm still a rock star, I got my rock moves, and I don't want you tonight.
I still wanna do Smell Your Dick, though.
We are not doing Smell Your Dick. We did another.
We're not. Thank you, James. We're
well, you know what that means?
What?
It means you need to watch out. Watch out for my knife. You might have run into my knife 10 times.
Okay. Okay.
You were screwing the milkman. You were screwing the milkman.
Enough.
Enough is enough. I can't go on. I can't go on no more. No. Always dreamed I found the perfect lover,
but he turned out to be like every other man I love.
I had no choice from the start. I got to listen to my
if I got that last note.
That was your Heather Headley moment.
Is it? No.
We'll work on that.
We'll work with it.
I loved it. I still gotta pee.
You do.
I'm kidding.
Oh. Well, we love that you're here.
Yes.
You beautiful,
thank
wonderful
you
people.
For
and
coming.
Also to you wonderful people live streaming us tonight.
Right there.
You're marvelous.
Yes.
Who's in the audience? Let's see. Let's take a survey. Yeah. I see Hisham's here. What are you eating? Everything.
Yes.
But I know you need, like, is it gluten-free? Because I know that's very important.
Very important. Vinny's here.
Vinny's here.
Jordan's here.
Melody Beauty, who is friends with Farah.
Fern is here. Hi, Fern. This is lovely. So here's how we usually do our show. We start with our theme song, a nonsensical medley, burping, and then there's a segment called 3 Minutes.
3 Minutes.
It's in the title.
Yes.
It's usually...
Three minutes
long. And we pick something to just sort of ramble on.
Yes.
For 3 minutes.
And so, Drew.
Yes, ma'am.
If you would hit it, please.
3 minutes on the clock.
On the clock. Yes. Look, there's a clock. You know, the only reason Port Authority exists is what, well, the Jamba Juice.
Mm.
There's no good reason to have Port Authority in New York City. Just Jamba Juice.
You know, it's just there. It's just being all big and transit hubby-like, useless.
I feel like if you fell asleep in a Port Authority, well, in the Port Authority, you'd probably wake up with no liver.
I feel like if you fell asleep at a Port Authority, you'd be tooken. Like in Taken, you know? You'd end up in a G-string being sold to somebody.
Did you just say tooken? Tooken.
Englishy.
It's English adjacent. Who could ask for anything more? You know, Port Authority really just knows how to do it. The Jamba Juice, Strawberries Wild was amazing today.
The mango one is nice too. They're just great. Don't you have you like one too?
Oh, I like the razzmatazz.
It's fresh.
Oh, God.
It's refreshing.
Yeah. It's sweet and it's cool.
Yes, and it's got cold little chunks of fruit.
Oh, the fruit chunks.
Ice fruit chunks. Who could ask for anything more? You know, Jamba Juice, they don't get credit for inventing the smoothie. They
reinventing the smoothie. Not like that, what was that raggedy one? Juice Generation.
Oh yeah, or some of those other ones like Juice Press.
Like, when did juice get so pressed?
Yeah. You know.
And what about that Joe the Juice?
You know, who really is Joe? We need to investigate. Why does everything in Joe's juice have to have like avocado?
True.
And hemp milk.
That's why I'm an original. I'm a classic. I like to keep it simple. I am an original. I am a classic. I am Jamba Juice.
That's deep. That's real deep, girl. That's good.
Who could ask for anything more? Who could ask for anything more?
3 minutes. 3 minutes on Jamba Juice. Like, who knew? Do you want to tell the story of Jamba Juice?
Is it about Jamba Juice or is it about Port Authority? What did you think it was about?
I think it's about friendship.
It's about friendship.
That's sweet.
We used to go there a lot
when we were working at Playwrights.
Mm-hmm. We did something called Off-Broadway.
Off-Broadway. It's very artistical and it doesn't pay well.
Rather than walking down 42nd Street, we would walk through Port Authority. So it's real classy and you can pee.
Actually, the bathroom at Port Authority is quite nice.
I
was very surprised. It's not like a hellhole. It's decent. Yeah.
I'm gonna let you hold on to that.
Exactly. We're gonna trust you on that one, buddy.
Oh, come on now.
Tonight's musical selections have a bit of a theme.
James has been in rehearsals.
I've been very busy.
And so I kind of ran with shit.
Mm-hmm. I got a text message and a voicemail saying, here's what we're doing.
Here's what we're doing.
Learn it. And show up.
So I've been in a bit of a Hall and Oates mood of late.
I don't blame you.
And like, you know, they do the thing.
Daryl Hall is still singing. Daryl Hall is somewhere right now singing.
Sings.
And Oates is there.
Oates is there. And Oates
does things. Oates does things.
Yeah. So we're gonna start with a classic Hall & Oates song.
Ooh. I'm doing it with no glasses.
Hey, the whole night. You're a rich girl and you've got gone too far, cause you know it don't matter anyway.
You can rely on the old man's money.
You can rely on the old man's money.
It's a bitch, girl, and you've gone too far, cause you know it don't matter anyway.
Same money, but it won't get you too far, get you too far.
And don't you know, take what he's given you so far gone
on your own.
You could get along if you try to be strong, but you'll never be strong.
Cause you're rich, girl.
Rich girl.
You've gone too far, cause you know it don't matter anyway. You can rely on the old man's money.
You can rely on the man's money.
It's a bitch, girl.
Bitch, girl.
And it's gone too far, cause you know it don't matter anyway.
Same. You can rely,
but it won't get you too far, get you too far.
Can't read.
High and dry.
High and dry out in the rain.
It's so easy
to hurt others when you can't feel pain.
And don't you know,
don't you know,
that love can't grow.
Cause there's too much to give.
Cause you'd rather live for the
thrill of it all.
You're a rich girl.
Rich girl.
And you've gone too far. Cause you know it don't matter anyway.
Rich girl, you can rely on the old man's money.
You can rely on the old man's money. It's a bitch girl. And it's gone too far. Cause you know it don't matter anyway.
Say money, but it won't get you too far. Get you too far.
But it won't get you too far.
You can say money, but it won't get you too far.
Get you too far.
Hey, you're a rich girl.
Oh, yeah. Woo, woo, wee, wee. Squiddly ding dang boop squew. Sweet, sweet, squiddly dee, yeah.
I'm going to tell them what happened at soundcheck. Someone was riffing. So I'm just kind of watching this for the evening.
Squaddle ding ding boop squiddly doo. Squidwanga twang twang skiddle dee dwip dwip squiddle diddle twan on one way.
If you applaud for him, he'll stop. It's a mixed message. See?
Fine. I was just expressing where my artistic soul was today, but I guess my artistry should
maybe
be.
Maybe there'll be a moment later on. Maybe there'll
fine,
be something.
Fine, James.
I'm setting up a theme.
Fine.
Do you know what's next?
Well, we need to tell people about our guests.
Yes.
Farah Alvin.
Yes.
She stays working on Broadway.
Yep.
Been on the Broadway a bunch of times.
Broadway debut in.
Greece.
Then
She was in The Look of Love. Then she was in
Nine.
Then she was feeling miserable in Les Miserables. And then she said it should have been you on Broadway.
It's really fun to watch. I'm just...
Off Broadway, The Marvelous Wonderettes.
I love you because.
Enter Laughing. But why we're really here celebrating her?
Farah has a new album out.
Has a new album.
That if you do not download it tonight, the album is called On Vinyl.
It's great.
It is available everywhere that you can download albums.
It's great. I've been trying to get my 10,000 steps in every day. And so I've been listening to this album, and it's tremendous.
It's so good.
What's that song, The Line Man? I've always Wichita? Hated this song, Wichita Line Man. Her verse, I am the county. I hate that song.
What
her
she's
version
done with
of
amazing.
It is stunning.
Yes.
It's amazing. Check out Farah's album, available on download and streaming.
Called On Vinyl.
And we're going to hear from her.
Momentarily, but you're going to sing something.
I'm going to try to change the mood.
Are you going to emote?
I might do some emotifications.
Are you going to make people cry?
I'll try my best.
Do you want me to stand here and stare at you while you sing it? Because I don't want to.
Your breath is not great.
I love you. I'm going to go sit out.
I love you further away.
Okay. Goodbye.
Goodbye.
John Andrew Morrison.
So this is just a song that I love. I love my inner lesbian.
Let her out.
Call on her.
I'm going to.
Does she have a name?
Her name is Brandina Carlilia. She's my cousin.
I love you.
Oh, gosh. All of these lines across my face tell you the story of who I am. So many stories of where I've been and how I got to where I am. Oh, but these stories don't mean anything when you got no one to tell them to. Oh, it's true. I was made for you. I climbed across the mountain tops, swam all across the ocean blue. I crossed all the lines and I broke all the rules. But baby, I broke them all for you. Oh, because even when I was flat broke, you made me feel like a million bucks. Oh, it's true. And I was made for you. And you see this smile across my mouth. They're hiding the words that won't come out. And all of my friends who think that I'm blessed, they don't know that I am a mess. Oh, they don't know who I really am. And they don't know what I've been through like you do. I was made for you. And you see this smile across my face. These lines, they tell you the story of who I am. So many stories of where I've been and how I got to where I am. But these stories don't mean anything when you got no one to tell them to. Oh, it's true. I was made for you. Oh, yes, it's true. I was made for you. Oh, yes, it's true. I was made for you.
Aww. That was really pretty.
Squiddly-dee-doo-dweep-wop-wop-wop-squee.
The scat solo was the best part.
Spatwang bala twinky ba doo ba dee dee. Hey, Melody Butu, how is Hair Lies Love rehearsals going?
Yay!
Really? I am so fucking.
I can't wait.
Me too.
She's gonna be on the Broadway again. And it's amazing. It's amazing. She did the show off Broadway, and it was fantastic. Now she's doing. Are you okay, honey? What's the matter? No, you gotta share the joke. Oh, well, have you seen it? Have you seen her in it?
You have to.
She sings a song in the show and it's so fucking good. And she's so fucking good.
Does that also let out your inner lesbian?
Here Lies Love?
Yeah.
No, it lets out my inner Pinoy, I guess. my inner Filipino.
Love it. Yes.
And I gotta say, I mean, like, there ain't no party like a Filipino party. What? If you have not been to a Filipino party, you need to go. Mm-hmm. You're gonna be fed.
The food.
You will be fed. Roti. No, they got lumpia. They got lumpia and karaoke.
Exactly. They do put down the music
there.
The
singing is gonna be fire. The food is gonna be fire. You're gonna be fed. And it's going to be joyous, and you're going to have a good time. All right, so enough about my inner lesbian and inner Filipino. The moment is here.
Where do you want me to sit?
Sit where you want to sit.
I failed my stage management class today.
Well, there you have it.
I'll sit on the other side.
Yeah. We should put Farah in the middle, I think, right?
Yes. Yes.
So can you please...
Welcome to the stage.
Welcome to the stage and give a warm welcome. The marvelous, the scintillating, the wonderful, the glorious, Miss Farah Alvin!
Farah Alvin!
Wonderful.
Am I not?
No, you are.
Hi.
Now you are.
Hello.
Hi.
Oh, my goodness.
I'll be here in the middle.
Yes.
Yeah.
Yes.
I have the questions over
sandwich.
Here.
Sandwich.
Mm-hmm. Do you have anything to tell us about your life today? How was your commute?
How was your day?
I had like a technology shit show day.
Like tell
real
us about
everything
your technology
stopped
shit
show working. So something I'll talk about more tonight, I hope, is that this Friday we are doing the release concert for my album. So it's right here at Green Room 42, 7 p.m. on Friday. Huge band, horns, electric guitars. It's going to be very, very exciting. Mm-hmm. And we have a big band rehearsal tomorrow. And I had to do a lot of printing so that everyone can read their music. And my printer said no.
It said, not today. I am tired.
No.
I am
we
on
are
strike.
Sort of like slaves
I
to
am, I
technology.
Yeah.
I am with the WGA.
Oh,
that's
yeah.
what your printer said.
Yeah, that's right. My printer was like...
Your printer said, I am not airing the Tonys.
No pages.
Kidding.
No Tonys for you. Yeah. We're canceling everything.
Yeah. Yeah.
I say, shut it down.
Shut it down.
And pay people.
Square that way.
You don't want to see... Can you?
I can see from
swap?
Here.
Oh, you can?
Yeah.
I'm trying to not know
up.
What it says.
Oh, you, okay. Well,
I don't know what it
James
says.
James asked the questions.
So, okay. James, I'm going to look at you kind of like
sit
this.
Here and be pretty.
Well, no, so we're, so, look, we make our own stuff. You have made an album. Mm-hmm. Jam is now flirting with the audience. Our first question is about doing that, about like what attracts you to making your own work? Because you've done.
Yeah.
You have done it a lot.
I have made quite a bit of my own work, I guess. Yeah.
What's the thrill of that?
I think the thrill is sort of, you know, the romance of being your own boss, right? Mm-hmm. That you don't have to technically answer to anybody. But I actually think that it becomes more collaborative when you are doing something that your heart is in.
This is true.
Right? Yeah. That, like, sometimes if you're forced to collaborate, do you remember when you were a kid in school and they would make you do a group project?
Yeah.
And they would, like, make you work with people, and they'd often, like, push you into groups with people that you didn't necessarily socialize with. Sometimes, like, when you're working on something that isn't yours, that's what happens. You're like, well, okay, well, these are the people I'm working with, for good or for bad. But I think when you're creating something yourself, you get to pull your own people into the circle, you know?
And it feels good.
It does
we were just
feel
talking
about
good. This in the green room, in the dressing room, while we were all getting ready.
And then I guess, like, you know, because you have worked in the machine of Broadway mm-hmm. and like commercial off Broadway, mm-hmm. and so what is the different work ethic, I guess, between like okay, showing up, I have to be in this machine that's already made, and showing up and doing that fully, as opposed to all right, I'm going to create from the ground up something else.
I mean, honestly, for me, the work ethic is the same because I'm a super neurotic person and I just can't half-ass things. It's not in me to do. But the outcome is much more joyful, right? So it's sort of like, you know, when my son is 9 and he's like, isn't it fun? He's like sort of learning the concept of time flies when you're having fun for the first time, just in real time. So he'll be like, isn't it funny how when you're playing a video game or you're reading, it's just, you don't even notice how much time is passing. But when you're in school, it takes forever. And I'm like, yeah, that is funny. But I think it's sort of like, you know, when you're creating something and you don't have to sort of, I don't know, retrofit yourself into it.
Yeah.
You know, when it's like, oh, this really came from my heart. And what do you think? And that other person that you're collaborating with is like, yeah, 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 this comes from my heart. And that's what I think too. And then you kind of make this delicious thing in the middle of you, then it's just much more fun and the time is freer, right? You sort of feel like in the cut or in the flow of it. Whereas like, you know, I don't know who all here is in show business, everybody maybe, but you know.
Hit this mark at this point.
Yeah, exactly, stand on four, you know? And I've done a lot of understudying, which is a very interesting and wonderful experience, but it also sort of, you know, in these big, big machine type shows, it literally is like, oh, the person that you're covering actually raises her arm all the way to here, so you raised your arm to here, and we have 12 people are taking a cue off of that, so we really need you to get your arm all the way up into here, or we can't take the, you know, we can't move the scenery.
Yeah.
And so things like that are like,
important to someone else.
Yeah, exactly. 100%. Yeah, it's like just not about you, you know? But at the same time, I don't want to take those things for granted because I know
they're necessary. And it's also a safety concern.
Exactly.
You need to get it up or this pit is going to stay open and people might fall in.
People are going to fall and crack their head. Yeah.
That's what it's, you know, when James and I hold my hand.
Take it.
That's what it feels like when I'm collaborating with James. Don't hold my hand anymore. That's what it feels like when I'm collaborating with Drew.
Yeah. No, we, like this past couple weeks in particular, we've been very busy and on very opposite schedules and somehow have managed to figure out how to put this together via, like, I'll text you at 2 o'clock in the morning.
Absolutely.
But I'm going to respond at 5 o'clock in the morning.
Oh, gosh.
And then we'll figure it out. We'll meet in the middle somewhere.
Yeah.
Well, I'm glad you brought your son up because that takes us to our second question.
Okay.
Which is, you're a mom.
I'm a mom.
And how, that's like a big, huge life thing.
It's a human being. You know?
Okay.
But how has that like changed your perspective on being an artist, being a human being? Like, how has that impacted?
It changed everything.
What's the biggest surprise?
Everything. The biggest surprise is how little I care about like the creative stuff that we were just talking about that used to be like for 20 something years of my life was the 30 something. I had him when I was 36 years old. So, you know, the most important thing, like, you know, every dream, every other thing was like supplanted so that I could do that. And now I'm like, who cares? So, you know, that's surprising where you're kind of like, you know, my agent will call and be like, Broadway wants to. And I'm like, So, you know, because I don't want to like, so that's the biggest change. And then also when you're an older parent, now I'm used to it and he's like a normal person. He's 9. But you're older and they're babies, like you think as theater people, you're like, oh yeah, tired. I know what tired is. Yeah, we do tired all the time. We do all-nighters and we push through. And you have no idea. No idea. Just literally no idea. So like that was a surprise where I was like, oh.
This is what people are talking about.
This is like wartime tired. Tired. But I'm that we're done with now. But there's nothing quite like having like I went back to a Broadway show. He was 10 months old, you know? And he still was nursing.
What
and
show?
That was It Should Have Been You. It was my first job, my first big job back when he was little. And so he was still waking up to nurse in the middle of the night. And I got maybe 4 or 5 hours of sleep a night.
And doing a Broadway show.
Yeah, and standing by for two women, for Lisa Howard and for Montego Glover. And Lisa's character literally never left the stage. So some nights if like, and I was a dance captain. Because I wanted that $14 more a week. I wanted that 14 bucks. So I would sometimes, if I knew there would be no chance of going on, I would just put my little head down on my station and go to sleep. But you'd come in and there'd be some person that'd be like, oh, I'm so tired. I was laying out on my roof deck all morning. I think I got too much sun. I slept till 4 in the afternoon. And fuck yeah. You know, so that was sort of surprising, I guess, that level of anger toward my fellow man.
That is too funny.
But he's great, and he's hilarious, and my favorite thing about him is just sort of figuring, like, him showing me who he is, like, as he figures out who he is, you know?
Oh, that's lovely.
That.
That's nice.
That. Yeah. I have a question.
Yes.
Because we just, I devoured some French fries in the dressing room.
Yeah, that helped.
And you have so this good. Entire side hustle revolving around wellness and nutrition.
Yes, yes, I
that
do.
That goes completely against all of the French fries the I French just inhaled
well,
with every fiber
it
of my being.
Completely against
it. Was a group
it.
Effort, but yeah. like some of us did better than others at removing French fries from the table.
Yeah.
But what, how did, where did that come about? What's this love of nutrition and
okay,
wellness?
So I have a whole other... okay, where did this begin? I have was like a sick kid, had a lot of health problems as a child. And then, and also into like the early parts of my career, just kind of always on the struggle bus with my health. And it's very hard, if you don't know, to do 8 shows a week and like always be getting sick. It's like really, really difficult to do. So through like long... My own, how do I tell this story quickly? My own process of like getting myself well, I sort of became like a wellness advocate. And when I was getting married and I knew at some point that we would want to start a family, I was thinking way ahead and I was like, well, you know, at some point if I get pregnant and I have a family, it's going to be harder for me to do a regional job. It'll be harder for, I won't be able to work while I'm pregnant, right. probably, you know, it, because people, you know, as we see Broadway shows, like, you know, they were clearly represent everybody, including pregnant people. You know, so...
So many different bodies on stage.
On stage.
Yes.
So
always.
Anyway, I also... So I was very passionate about it. And then also, concurrently, I kind of got real picky mid-career about what kind of stuff I wanted to do.
Yeah.
And so I was like, well, I kind of wanted to, like, be able to say no to things. So I said, what else am I passionate about? And so then I became a holistic health and wellness coach, which I've been doing for 13 years.
Wow.
Oh,
yeah,
really?
yeah. So Nourished with Farah Alvin.
Yes.
And I just like to sort of, I'm very passionate about traditional foodways and traditional medicine, like not traditional medicine like Western medicine, but like traditional medicine like herbal medicine and things like that. But also just sort of like how our ancestors ate. I'm always sort of a, like fascinated by the fact that like my grandfather grew up in New York City and had no refrigerator. So like, and probably no vaccines. And no, I mean, I vaccinate, but you know, and no antibiotics, right? And like somehow like grew up and was fine, you know? And that's fascinating to me that like people had like no access
drinking
to anything.
From the hose.
And lasted right? for a very long
yeah,
time.
Yeah, lived and had families and I'm here because of them. Yeah. And so I'm not going to try and make people like, you know, thresh sure. their own grain or whatever that is. But I'm not going to make you
I'm
do
sure
that,
someone in Brooklyn is already
they're
doing
out there doing
Brooklyn
it. Doing artisanal it. Grain
yeah.
threshing.
They
but
are. Yeah.
I spreading it on toast collective. And charging $75.
Like, exactly. Yeah. I just think there's so much noise out there about how to eat and how to take care of your body. And so much of it is so confusing and so diminishing. And so I just like to help people try and figure out how to return to their intuitive sense of what it means to be well in their own body. That's what I do.
You'll be getting a call from a John Andrew Morrison soon.
Okay, anonymous.
I've heard of
anonymous.
Farah Alvin.
you are, I'm going to ask the next question, Jane, because it's over here to my left.
Well,
you are a big singer. That's what
big.
I that's
singer.
What, it's a big voice. It's
big,
a big voice.
It's a big voice.
And you like big singers. Like you like the Ann Wilsons, the Joni Mitchells. Like,
yes.
Where's that love of big singers come from?
Oh, I mean, it literally just comes from trying to find voices that sounded like mine.
But
right?
like even as a kid, were you like these?
Okay,
I have to
so classic
to...
story. My mother. Okay, so you know when you're a little kid and your mom puts on like a record and like some beautiful little lullaby type of thing to fall asleep to. My mother would just put her record collection on for me. And so by the time I was 3, I listened mostly. And again, okay, also this is like old school stuff. Anybody's old enough. I used to have this record player that would, you could stack like 3 at the top, right?
Yeah.
So you listen to side A of one and then the next one to fall, you listen to side A of that one and the next one to fall, you listen to side A.
That was big technology.
Yeah. So I would listen often. I had a stack that was like the first Barbra Streisand album, and then My Name is Barbara, and then Judy Garland at Carnegie Hall. And then Ella Fitzgerald at Carnegie Hall.
Wow!
And so and that
How
was
old?
It. No, like 0 to 4.
Wow.
So I would like make everyone sit down in our living room, and my big number was Chicago, a la Judy's Encore at Carnegie Hall.
Yes.
You know, with the big breakdown, Chicago, light and easy town, that's my breezy town, at like 4. That was what I made people listen to. But then as I got older, you know, I would try and sing along with people, and you try and find your voice. Yeah. And I used to love to listen to, like, Patti LaBelle was a life-changing sound for me because my voice is really weirdly high. So I would just try and sing along to her and make my voice sound the way that her voice sounded.
On my own.
On my own. Raining and know the whole time. So, yeah, I mean, it's literally biological. And so that's also been like a thing too.
I did that with like the Indigo Girls. Like that's how I learned how to sing harmony.
Oh, yeah, exactly.
And because I'm a lesbian. Yes. I would sing along with Amy because I could like actually reach what her were very low notes for her. And they were very high notes for me, but I could match that and then learned how to sing harmony.
Exactly. And you just kind of mess around with like how it sits in your face, literally. Like what kind of weird mouth shape you have to make to make a sound. You know, and in your car, that's good because nobody's looking at you.
Yeah.
Not even you. So, yeah, I mean, that's how it was. It's just biological, and my voice sits very high and is very loud, and I used to get in trouble in school all the time for talking.
Did she get in trouble all the time in school?
Oh, well, when I was little. No, I mean, Melody and I were, like, drama nerds together.
Oh, okay.
In high school. But, it would always be like, I would be like, you know, John Andrew, please stop talking. And they'd be like, Farah, stop talking. Because my voice would carry. So, it's an old-fashioned theater voice. Yeah.
When you were in drama club class together.
Yes.
Did you all have, who was the boy that you all had crushes on?
Oh.
I don't know. Did we? Greg Lennington. Yeah. Hi, Greg. I wonder if you're watching.
Why? What was it about Greg Lennington?
He just had it. He had it.
He had it?
Yeah, he had it. He just had long hair. It was the 90s.
Not in the theater department. Wow. Like,
it's very bluey, I think.
Was he straight?
Yeah. Yeah, still
I
is.
I tell you, straight boys in theater can clean up.
Yeah. Good call, Melody. I forgot, but yeah, for sure. Yeah.
Clean up.
You're going to sing something from your album.
I'm going to sing something from my album, yeah.
Tell us, like, why this album? Why on vinyl? Why the songs you chose? Why? What is this about?
So, in the year was 2019... In the fall of 2019, Green Room 42 reached out to me and they said, would you like to do a show here? And I hadn't done a cabaret show in I don't know how long, 15 years, something like that. And I said, yes, what would you like me to do? And they said, well, do whatever you want. And I went, well, what do I really want to do? And I thought, well, what I'd really like to do is the music that means the most to me. It's not necessarily the music people ask me to sing, but I was like, the music that I listen to all the time and have been listening to since high school is stuff from the 60s and the 70s. And so I collaborated with my music director and arranger, Michael Holland, and I said, would you be into this? And he was like, yeah, I'd be really into that. And we put the show together in 2019, and I thought, like, well, we like it. I hope other people like it. And it turns out that, like, that music, which I think is, like, my music, is, like, a lot of people's music. Yeah. Like, people are like, oh, this song, this song, this song, this song. So we did... on vinyl two times before, we called the show On Vinyl. We did it two times before the pandemic. And then
never heard of it.
No? Do you miss that one? All right, there was a thing. I'll tell you about it later. I'll send you an article. Then things shut down and then they let people back into this space. And that was in 2021, and I came back and I did. It was just Michael and I because we were honestly afraid to have a lot of people up here.
Yeah.
And so then we did just sort of like just the two of us, like more songs, and we called that show B-Side. And so at that point, not knowing if like the world would end again, or, you know, it was a kind of, if you recall, 2021 was strange, like... can we do this again? We decided to crowdfund, and we put the, everyone said after the first show, they said, will you please record this? I would listen to this all the time because the songs, again, were like so meaningful to people. So we spent a long time crowdfunding and then a long time recording, and COVID set us back several times during the recording process, and then we finally got it together. So now it's out, and you can listen to it on any streaming platform, wherever you listen to music, you can listen to it. If you are a CD person, I have CDs. You're welcome to purchase one for me. It's actually a very beautiful package I feel very proud of. But if you
Is it also on vinyl?
It will be on vinyl. It will be. It will be on vinyl. People are like, is it going to be
right?
No, exactly. No, it's definitely
people
a thing.
People have record players
And
again.
We definitely want to do it. And it's long. We made kind of a long album, and so the place that does like a lot, like the common manufacturer, they're like, it's too long. So I have to find some special niche. Like I have to go to Williamsburg or something. Like, say, hey, and they made a long record, and they'll be like, cool.
Records.
So yeah, exactly.
Okay.
So I have to work that part out. Also, everything is so expensive, you guys. Everything is so expensive. But anyway, we're gonna put a lot of money on the stage on Friday. So.
Yeah, yes. The sound of this album is fantastic.
Thank you.
Big band. There are horns and strings.
Horns and strings.
And it's
There's
really,
a choir. There's
it's
a lot.
Really good. It's really, really good.
You're gonna sing something.
I'm gonna sing something. Yeah, yeah, yeah.
We have to do our stage management too.
Oh, I should have gotten up and been doing that, but I failed. Also, my leg fell asleep.
That was a fascinating interview. It made James's. Leg fall asleep.
Well,
can
the
I have
thing
that?
Is, yeah, but my jeans are too tight.
Oh,
my goodness.
I'll have two.
Jeans are too tight.
Look, I'm failing
on
all
jeans.
Fronts.
Blame
Look,
it on
my
the jeans.
Pants, these pants, there's a whole story about these pants. Child. Anyway.
Okay. Let me see. Do you want, I can move this one out of the way. Where's we have to go somewhere.
There's things.
We're going over here.
Where
things
we go?
Are being bussed.
So production value. What,
yeah.
It's, great
it's
stage
unreal.
Managers,
amazing.
You know
Thank
what I mean?
You. Thank
How
you.
Do you do it?
What?
How do you do it?
You know, I went to school.
We need a direct eye line to Drew.
Yes.
Okay. Just in case we felt like singing backup.
Yeah, we're kind of throwing this Allegedly. Together. I have backup singers. These two terrific ladies named Janine Bruin and Alexis Rochelle, who'll be with me on Friday. But we're going to see what happens with this team tonight.
We know what we're doing.
Well, yeah. She's singing a Gladys Knight song, so we're going to be the Gips. The Gay wow. Pips.
Yeah.
You came up with that all by yourself.
I like it.
If I were your woman and you were my man, you'd have no other woman, you'd be weak as a lamb. If you had the strength to walk out that door, my love would overrule my sense, and I'd call you back for more. If I were your woman,
if I were your woman.
She tears you down, darling, says you're nothing at all. But I'll pick you up, my darling, when she lets you fall. You're like a diamond, but she treats you like glass. Still you beg her to love you, but me you don't ask. If I were your woman, if I were your woman,
I never know.
Thank you.
Her album is called On Vinyl.
On Vinyl.
And every one of you has a phone that you could actually download it with right now.
It's pretty damn fantastic. Ooh. No, you're not done yet.
Oh, we're not done with you yet, ma'am.
Back.
Miss.
My.
Thank you.
While you're here at Green Room, you can make your reservation for Friday. Please.
Oh, that is
Friday.
True. That's true.
Big show. Big show. Big.
Oh, wow. So.
Thanks, guys. That was good. That was good bipping. It was good.
I started in the wrong octave. I got it.
It's okay.
You got there.
It's
look.
Okay.
You found it.
We also, in continuing with Jam's theme of.
Sweetle, tweetle, twang, twang, spoodle, diddy, weep, weep.
Sometimes you have to just let him go.
I know, I like it. Yeah. I'm like,
this is what I go through. This is what I go through.
Wow.
He also says that he cannot riff. So
exactly.
When this happens, I have to let it go. Okay, wow, you stretched first or something.
I did.
But we're putting everyone that we asked to be guests. Through the ringer of being forced to sing with us and create a trio out of something that is not a trio.
And because I was in the Hall & Oates mood, I asked Farah, what Hall & Oates song would you like to sing? And she said, this one.
Very 80s.
She only come out at night, the lean and the hungry type. Nothing is new, I've seen her here before. Watching and waiting, oh, she's sitting with you, but her eyes are on the door.
So many have paid to see what you think. For free, the woman is wild, but she kept tamed by the pearl of a jaguar. Money's the matter. If you're in it for love, you ain't gonna get too far.
Not gonna get too far, no.
Oh, here she comes. Watch out, boy, she'll chew you up. Oh, here she comes. She's a man-eater. Oh, here she comes. Watch out, boy, she'll chew you up. Oh, here she comes.
Here she comes, she's a man-eater.
I wonder if I were you, I know what she can do. She's a deadly man. She could really rip your world apart. Mind over matter. Oh, the beauty is, but there's a beast in her heart. Hey, yeah. Oh, here she comes. Watch out, boy, she'll chew you up. Oh, here she comes. She's a man-eater. Oh, here she comes.
Here she comes.
Watch out, boy, she'll chew you up. Oh, here she comes, she's a man-eater.
Now you clap.
Oh, here she comes, watch out, boy, she'll chew you up. Oh, here she comes, she's a man-eater. Oh, here she comes, watch out, boy, she'll chew you up. Oh, here she comes,
watch out,
she's a man-eater. Oh, here she comes, watch out. Oh, here she comes,
watch out.
Oh, here she comes,
watch out.
Oh, here she comes.
Oh, here she comes, watch out.
Oh, here she comes,
watch out.
Oh, here she comes,
watch out.
Man-eater.
Man-eater. She's gonna chew you up and spit you out. And chew you up again, and spit you out, and chew you, and chew you, and chew you, and eat you. She's a man-eater.
Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you.
She's still chewing and spitting and eating and chewing.
Wow.
And eating and chewing.
Watch
and
out.
Chewing.
ladies and
watch
gentlemen.
Out!
Ladies and gentlemen, Farah Alvin.
Yeah!
Farah, the way that we typically...
I keep trying to leave.
No, you don't get to leave yet. You thought you could leave after that foolishness? Never!
The way that we usually wrap up our thing,
got it.
We're like mirroring. Nearing that part. But we like to send people off with one wish. Oh, no, we have... But there's like a whole game.
We have a whole
game. We didn't even play our games yet.
My God.
Oh, my God.
Go sit down.
This is what happens when I'm not at rehearsal.
Okay.
My God.
Oh.
Right now, we play games.
Yep.
And there is a game that is very dear and near to my heart.
Oh,
it's very important.
This is why I didn't remember it.
This game is very important to mankind.
It's terrible.
And the name of this game is Stinky Mouth, Sloppy Mouth. Stinky Mouth, Sloppy Mouth.
Sweeping the nation, obviously.
Farah Alvin.
Yeah.
This is how you play Stinky Mouth, Sloppy Mouth.
Okay.
You are tasked to give the world's most beautiful screen kiss ever.
Mm-hmm. Okay.
And you're working with the most fabulous person. You get along famously.
Okay.
But, A, this person has enjoyed craft services a little bit too much, and his tuna breath renders his mouth a little stinky.
Okay.
Or, his breath is perfectly fresh,
okay.
But it just seems to have a lot of excessive saliva, rendering him
sloppy.
A sloppy mouth.
Okay.
Farah Alvin!
Yeah.
Who are you kissing? Are you kissing the stinky mouth or the sloppy mouth? The world wants to know.
And why?
And why?
Because, you know.
Okay. I'm going sloppy mouth here.
Okay, okay.
I don't know
that's
if that
a quick
is controversial.
Decision,
is that controversial
no,
choice?
No, no,
no.
People
seem going impressed.
Going sloppy
people
mouth.
People like that a lot.
Why
okay.
Sloppy?
People vote sloppy. Okay.
Because intimacy sometimes is like little, you know, messy and
you're all right with the messy.
I'm all right with that. Also, like, I just feel that I can handle that, right? You just kind of get your hand in, right? And like a wipe, you know? Oh, and if it were on screen, like, someone would be like monitoring
the
sloppiness.
The slop, yes.
Like, someone would be on top of that, but it would be very difficult for me to be like, this person's breath is unfresh.
Okay.
Right?
All right.
Also, like, that's just a lot. Like, it's even, you know, like, when you're singing, even if you don't have to do the kiss, like, on stage, or you have, like, singing with somebody, and they just had, like, 4 cups of coffee that morning, the coffee breath, it's not good.
It's, yeah.
It's not a good
stuff.
So I think, tough sell.
Okay.
I vote sloppy.
Melody Booty, are you kissing the stinky mouth or the sloppy mouth?
Sloppy.
Wow.
Team sloppy.
Are there any stinky mouths in the audience? Is there a stinky mouth anywhere?
Wow.
Looking for a stinky mouth? No.
Interesting. Okay. For the future of that game.
Wow. Okay.
Now, another game we also like to play that I love is called Pick a Pair of Patties.
Yes.
Sweeping the Nation. Joe Biden's playing it later
yes,
this month.
Yes, he is.
Okay.
If he has time.
Okay.
It's in the title, Pick a Pair of Patties. We are going to give you a scenario.
Okay.
We've played this game for probably the last almost two years.
Always
and
interesting.
Always
okay.
interesting.
Yes,
never. There's no wrong answer.
Okay.
But we're trying to add a switch to some of it today. So well, we're going to give you a scenario.
Yeah, because I have a thing after that you don't even know about. So
oh
you do the
God,
original
surprise.
One. Surprise.
Somebody brought tricks.
Okay.
I did.
Okay. So in my version
okay.
of the good game, you're picking a pair of patties. We have to pick two.
Okay.
A pair. The scenario in question is a bank heist.
Okay.
So there's a bank robbery. You have to plan it. You're sort of the producer of a bank heist.
Got it.
You need to hire a heavy, someone to do like a, give me all your money.
Okay, okay.
And then someone to drive the getaway car.
Okay.
Someone to do like a step on it.
Okay, okay.
So you have to pick a pair of patties. You have 3 patties to choose from, and
okay.
you got to pick two of them.
Okay.
Because that would be a pair.
Got it.
Patty LuPone.
Okay.
Broadway's Patty LuPone. Broadway's Patty Murin.
Oh, okay.
Sweet as pie, frozen.
Yes.
And America's sweetheart, Patti LaBelle.
Oh, okay. Okay.
So,
okay.
Oh,
now,
but there's a twist for specifically.
We've
you.
Added a twist because
for me. Okay.
We played the game for almost 2 years now. But the new twist, okay. Since you do love big voices, and these are three big voices,
yeah.
We're looking for a pair of them, someone okay. to be the heavy, the give me all your money, mm-hmm. and someone to be the getaway driver. Yeah. Step on it.
Yeah.
You must. We're going to try this out, and we feel like you're the right person
no.
to try this out.
Yeah.
In the choosing of your pair of patties, Lapone, uh-huh. Murin, or LaBelle, uh-huh. you have to sing your response.
Oh,
you have to
God.
Sing, give me all your money,
okay.
or step on it as whoever
okay.
you're choosing. Which is, it's almost meta.
Yeah, yeah, it's like
okay.
this.
Yeah.
Yeah. Wow. I'm not good at impersonations, but
me neither.
Okay,
me neither.
We're going to see but what
we're
happens.
And even if you needed a chord of any sort, we
sure.
have Drew here.
Oh,
and,
wow, okay.
So
okay.
the first one were
the heavy.
The heavy, okay.
Give
someone
me all
to
your money.
Give me all your money.
Okay, so I think just based on what I understand of this person's personality mm-hmm. and like the resonance you would need her that to carry through
yeah.
a bank space,
banks
I'm
going to
opt for Lapone.
Absolutely.
For the give me all your money.
Okay.
Yeah.
That tracks.
Okay.
That tracks.
Thank you. Thank you for your support.
We can clap for Patti LaPone because if we don't, we don't know.
So really in her throat, right? Like, give me all your money.
That's yes.
But like one note. I'm
but
not
that's
gonna
right.
ask her to like go up.
No, no, it yes. doesn't have to.
But, strong, okay.
And just vowels.
That's very Evita. It's
yeah.
very like.
That's it. Give me your money, I support you.
Yeah.
Right. Okay. And then who that's is driving the getaway
yeah.
car? Who is
okay, so
the
I'm
step
my
on it.
My vote here is LaBelle, and the reason why mm-hmm. is twofold.
Because she has a heavy foot.
That's well,
jams,
no, I don't know. There, this must because the internet is forever. This must be somewhere. But Patti LaBelle used to talk about her exercise regimen, which was that she has a gigantic property and like a big backyard with a pool, and that her what she did for exercise was put on her like 3.5-4-inch heels and just walk.
Tip around the pool.
That's what she did for exercise. And so I just feel that like when you've got a big high heel on, your foot is just kind of primed to go right for the gas pedal.
Yeah.
You know?
With a nice hard
and I
step
also
on
feel
it.
Like it kind of her voice is kind of a siren, like
yeah,
oh,
like,
yeah.
Like stand, like can't do it right. When she goes like a like there.
There's something. I love
it's
it.
In there.
I love
it's
it.
In there.
I love it.
Right,
not in a million years
with her
would I ever
tongue.
Have those notes.
That's my favorite. That's my favorite.
That's fantastic.
JM, what is your twist to pick a pair of panties? He's so happy.
I came up with this today, and it said, pick a pair of patties, all skate.
Okay.
This is how it goes.
So frightened.
The scenario is, you are on a deserted island.
Okay.
With all three of these patties.
Okay.
Well, then it's not deserted because there's four people.
Except for just the four of you all.
Okay. Okay.
And nobody else.
Okay.
Okay.
And you have somehow become the king of the island.
Okay.
Sort of Lord of the
yeah.
Fly style.
Okay. Who's got
which
the conch?
One is helping you to build shelter?
Oh.
Which one is building the fire?
Okay.
And which one are you all going to eat for dinner?
Terrible. Terrible.
Wow.
However, that's I already fun. Have my answers.
I want to know James's
answers. I fully
answers.
Have my answers prepared and ready. I did not know how ready
all skate.
Life
who's
has
building
made me
shelter,
for this.
Who's building fire, and who is going into the fire to get cooked?
Who is going
cooked?
To be the dinner?
LaBelle is obviously building the fire with
yeah.
me because she can cook a meal.
But she
gives us
like all those cookbooks, right?
Yeah.
LaBelle
yeah.
cuisine, right? So I'm not cooking. Huh?
Patti Murin is going to help me build a lovely home.
Yeah, this is like my exact choice.
You're eating LaPone?
100%.
Yeah.
100%.
Yeah.
Now, my answer is exactly for the same
absolutely.
Reason.
What?
I will proudly say that. I'm eating Danny
I am Pope. Scandalized. Yep.
What would you do?
I just asked the question. I don't
that's
answer.
A good one. Do you have it? Do you have an answer?
No, that's my exact the, for the exact same yeah, reasons. Yeah. I literally thought Patti LaBelle has to help with the cooking because yeah. she's yes. very qualified.
I feel like she could even like keep the fire going.
I'm like, just you like, know, wasn't Patty Murren like, wasn't she Anna? Like yeah, Patty Murren was like Anna, like was. Scrappy, yeah. you know, yes, like yes. industrious, and
she literally yeah. says it like, "Do you want to build a snowman?"
Yeah, so she's she makes buildy. Things. She's a buildy girl.
She's a builder.
She makes
wow.
things.
That's right.
But yes. you're eating Lapone.
Wow. It's a kind of a process of elimination. I yeah. think.
I mean, I feel like you better be ready to fight. She ain't going down without a fight. She's
you
like,
have started something.
Eat me.
You. Wow.
So you better be ready.
Wow.
Yeah.
These I had, are good.
I
really was not expecting that.
I thought we were kind of, it's kind of a Mary fuck Barry. Yeah. Is kind of what it is.
Yes, it is. It's, it a, is. Kind it's of, a variation on fuck Mary kill.
Yeah.
That was excellent. Thank you for that.
You're
oh,
welcome.
Yeah. I mean, really, like, we're simpatico. Yeah. We immediately. So if James is on the island also, then we're definitely eating.
Right.
Eating
How would
Lapone.
You answer, Jordan?
Oh,
you would pick the same.
I love oh. it. I love it. I love it. These are great. These are wow. great.
Is anybody eating anybody else? All right.
I love this audience.
No one right. wants to like venture into the
We're
this
moving
catamaran.
On.
Wow.
We're moving you on. All just at Patti Lapone. I said we're moving now. Oh yeah. You just ate.
Oh yeah!
I gotta pee.
Thank you.
It's my joke.
Is that it? Can I go?
Well,
no.
This is how we go.
I
we usually
that.
Wrap everything up by sending people off with one wish. Now, one wish is a lovely, just way to
wish.
Send people off into the world.
Yeah,
I don't know.
It's just a well-wishing. And why do we do one wish?
We do one wish because genies give you three,
right?
And I don't like genies.
Oh,
so you get one.
Is that racist?
It's maybe. Like I really should check that.
All right,
I'm gonna check. It. It's possible.
Is that a blind spot, James?
It might be, I've got several, which means technically, how am I even up here?
I'm trying to think what my one wish would be tonight. My one Ooh. Wish to send everyone off with would be around choosing joy. And it doesn't mean that shit ain't going to happen.
Because it
and
does.
And it doesn't mean that life is not going to happen. Mm-hmm. But somehow, I don't know, I've had to learn to choose joy. Mm. Because, you know, there have been good things, but there's also been like, some hard shit, mm-hmm. but somehow being in joy has helped to find some clarity in all of that. So if you can, find ways to stay in joy, whatever that means or what that looks like for you. I've been taking walks.
You have been.
And right. they've been great.
Yeah.
So whatever you need to do to find some more to come of joy in this world. That is my wish for you.
Thank you.
That's beautiful.
What about you, Miss Farah Alvin?
I wish that the creative people working in the Writers Guild could be paid fairly for their work. Mm-hmm. So that we can all begin to enjoy and continue to enjoy all of the many things that creative people offer to us. Yeah. So I wish that people would honor fair wages.
Oh,
that's good.
That's very good. That's
Fabulous.
Very good.
All right, Farah, now we get to leave.
Ladies and gentlemen, Farah Alvin.
Yes.
Thank Farah you. Alvin.
We thank you so much.
Oh my gosh, thank you for having me.
Thank you.
Love
on, On vinyl, the concert is this Friday.
Yes, right here.
But also, you can get the album right now. Yeah, it really is good.
Just right now. Just open up your thing, and if you start
open
hearing,
up your thing,
you'll hear it and in the middle of their show. Anyway, thank you.
Thank you.
Thank you.
You're marvelous.
Farah Alvin, everybody.
How's still that?
Well, of late, the wonderful, magnificent James Jackson Jr. Mm-hmm. has been answering his one wish
in song.
And so I'm going to leave the stage and let him do just that.
I love when you saunter off the stage.
I'm professional at it.
You are a good saunterer. My one wish is about what? Trusting your instincts. Instincts. My instinct was to say instinct improperly. And I trust it fully. No glasses. It's been a long time since I came around. It's been a long time, but I'm back in town. This time, I'm not leaving without you. It tastes like whiskey. When you kiss me, I would give anything again to be your baby doll. This time, I'm not leaving without you. He said, sit back down where you belong. In the corner of the bar with your high heels on. Sit back down on the couch where we made love the first time. And you said to me, there's something about this place. There's something about lonely nights and my lipstick on your face. There's something about that cool Nebraska guy. There's something about, baby, you and I. It's been 2 years since I let you go. Couldn't listen to a joke or your rock and roll. Muscle cars, they rode a truck right through my heart. On my birthday, you sang me a heart of gold with a guitar strumming and no clothes. This time, I'm not leaving without you. Sit back down where you belong, in the corner of the bar with your high heels on. Sit back down on the couch where we made love the first time. And you said to me, there's something about this place. There's something about lonely nights and my lipstick on your face. There's something about just knowing when it's right. There's something about, baby, you and I. Nebraska and Jesus Christ. There's something,
Something about the chase. I'm a New York woman born to run you down. So wipe my lipstick all over your face. There's something, something about just knowing when the shit's right. So put your drinks up for Nebraska. Oh, Nebraska, Nebraska, I love you, boy, you and I.
Come end the show?
I mean, I think they need to just give you another round of applause because that was fucking brilliant.
Well, thank you. Thank you very much.
And
thank
like, you know, you are one of my joys, James Jackson Jr.
You are one of my joys, John Andrew Morrison.
One of the greatest joys is that I got to spend all of this time working on a little show with you. And
what show was that?
With you. They know. It was off Broadway and on Broadway and in your hearts and in your minds. So
one of the biggest thrills of my life.
One of the biggest thrills of my life is becoming friends with James Jackson Jr. and putting shows together with Drew Watkey here at the Green Room 42.
And writing songs.
And writing songs.
It's lovely.
It's lovely.
I like what you did there.
So we always end with a little ditty
from that a little I never show know the words to.
Called Sesame Street. That the
is
Carpenters.
Is it from Sesame Street?
It
they
is.
They did it in Sesame Street, and then the Carpenters did it, and it ended up in Sesame Street.
Exactly.
One of yeah. But it's one of my favorite songs, and it's become our closer for our show. And there's going to be a moment where you get to sing with us. Mm-hmm. And you will know. And we expect you to sing. Okay.
There's also a section where Jam gets to riff.
Who knew? Maybe I riff throughout the song. We shall see. Sing. Sing a song. Sing out loud and sing out strong. Sing of good things, not bad. Sing of happy, not sad. Oh, sing. Sing a song. Make it simple to last your whole life long. Don't worry that it's not good enough for anyone else to hear. Just sing, sing a song.
Frisky.
Hey, sing, sing a song. Let the world sing along. Sing of how things should be. Sing for you and for me. Oh, 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 oh. Sing, sing a song and make it simple, simple.
Let your
sing, sing a song.
Now
you la 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 la
la
la la la la la la la la la la la la la la la la la
do it one more time
la 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 la
la la la la
la la la la la la la
la la
la la la la la la la la la la la la la la la la la
thank you so much.
Yes, thank you so much
for coming out this evening.
Thank you. Our next show, our final show in this residency, is going to be June 12th.
June 12th.
And we're calling it the Black Pride, No Tonys.
Pre-Juneteenth.
Pre-Juneteenth show.
Yes. All of those things will be discussed.
Yes.
And maybe televised since we wrote it.
It might be since we wrote it.
I said if they had let us host the Tonys, none of this would have happened.
None of this would happen if they let us host the Tonys. But they won't do that because
wow.
I can't really moonwalk.
Was that your MJ audition?
That's why I didn't get the part. Thank you, Sheridan.
Thank you so much.
You most beautiful, magnificent human being.
Thank you to the Green Room 42.
Green Room 42.
Thank you, Farah Alvin.
Farah Alvin, we love you.
Thank you, Drew Whatke. Thank you,
Drew Whatke. Drew Whatke.
Thank you for coming to Five Questions with James and Jam.
Thank you. We love you too.
Do you want to end the song?
Yeah.
Maybe. Don't worry that it's not good enough for anyone else to hear. Just sing.
Sing.
Sing a song. Oh. Thanks for coming!
Give it up for Five Q's with James and Jam!